Alibaba stock, ticker symbol BABA. This company, despite the lack of attention on the stock right now, it has been on a massive run. And let me show you, because today alone, it's up 3.56%. That's a massive one-day uptick. Not a five-day uptick, not a one-month uptick. One day alone, up 3.56%. And surprisingly, despite the continual declines around the market more broadly, if you zoom out, it gets even better. Five-day returns, actually positive, while the rest of the market has been falling down, up 0.86%. And one-month returns, look at this. One-month returns, up 21.33%. This is what I've been saying. Whilst the rest of the marketplace is distracted, while the rest of the marketplace is looking away at other equities, stressing about the US, Big Fang tech, whatever, falling apart, stocks like this, stocks where the attention has moved away, these are the best place to be making. Because when the market is neglecting an equity, that is the time to make a play. I was saying all but a month ago or so, back down this price, saying, listen, I think attention's moving away. People aren't looking as much at Alibaba as they once were, but a few months ago. And now we're getting the uptick. Now we're getting the continued rise. Yes, it doesn't make up for the declines over the past few months, still down around 5.13% over the past 6 months. But from that low of around, what was it, $81, we're up around 48.14%. Massive uptick. Year to date is almost negative or almost positive, only down around negative 0.21%. You can tell I'm out of breath. I'm astounded by the fact that Alibaba stock is actually going up for once, because for so long, we've been feeling the pain. Over the past 1 year, down 43.23%. That has been the color, that has been the narrative associated with Alibaba stock. But finally, we're seeing a turnaround. Finally, we're seeing upside taking place within this equity. So, what are my thoughts? After an almost 50% uptick from that low, is it still a viable buy? Is it still a undervaluation opportunity? Or is the opportunity gone? We should be looking elsewhere for other opportunities. When you break it down, not focusing on that day-to-day price movement, but instead actually looking at the business, actually looking at the financial stability, the profitability, the room for growth and further margin accretion associated with this business, you get a very simple, a very compelling answer. And that answer is yes. There is still very much a buying opportunity present. Let me show you why. Because when we break it down, the financial stability of Alibaba is unchanged. Financial stability is still very much present within this company. A very strong cash to debt ratio of 3.22. The ability, if they so desired, to instantaneously pay off all their debt obligations and then still have cash on hand to reinvest and build out the company going forward. They are in an extremely advantageous position when it comes to their cash on hand. Because think about it, with the potential of a recession on the horizon, so many investors saying, listen, recession's on the way, recession this year, next year, almost definitely. Do you know what's so important in the recession? What's so important for a company to hold? It's cash on hand. Because cash on hand acts as oxygen during a recession. It allows companies like Alibaba to survive and thrive in that recessionary environment. So, with cash on hand, combined with operational free cash flows constantly flowing in from both their cloud services and their large-scale platform e-commerce operations, the company's in a fantastic position. A very, very advantageous long-term growth position relative to other competitors within the marketplace. That cash on hand leaves them with a tremendous degree of underlying financial stability. And it's reinforced not only by that cash on hand and free cash flow accretion, but also the other financial stability metrics associated with this company. Equity assets of 0.56, debt to equity of 0.15, and even debt to EBITDA of 1.015. So massive financial stability evident within this business. And that's reflected by the improving Altman score. An Altman score moving up the scale, no longer within the distressed sector or the grey sector of the Altman scale, moving towards that safe range. An Altman score of 3.29 indicates that increasing degree of safety. And by the way, quarter over quarter, as they continue to reinvest, and as CCP, the Chinese Communist Party, continues to pull away from this company, that's only going to improve. Only more financial stability evident within this company. So, despite what the marketplace is saying, despite the consistent declines over the past year, financial stability remains stable. Financial stability, in fact, remains fairly advantageous for this company. But what about profitability? We know there's been margin declines with Alibaba across Pinduoduo, JD. The whole e-commerce sector more broadly has seen margin declines over the past year. But how does Alibaba stack up? Well, like many other companies, they have experienced declines. Net margins are down to only 6.41%. This is after being around 15% all but two or three quarters ago. So that's disappointing. That's underwhelming. But it is part of a larger secular trend. We're seeing JD.com with declining margins, Pinduoduo with declining margins, Mercado Libre, C Limited. We've seen all these other companies experience declining margins over the past year. So we know that isn't an exclusive issue to Alibaba. It's more of a sector industry-wide thing, which is somewhat gives a relief as an investor. It means you're not solely seeing underperformance in your business. It's more a secular-wide trend, which is okay. But still, we would like to see improvement going forward. But here's the thing. When you compare Alibaba's business to other companies within the sector, Alibaba is very unique in that it is a platform e-commerce business. Platform e-commerce business, relative to other large-scale logistics firms like JD.com, a platform e-commerce business has substantially lower marginal costs relative to those larger logistical firms. That means more margin accretion. That means high net margins over time. Combine that with Alibaba's cloud business, a massive free cash flow creating margin accretive business, and I think there's tremendous room for net margin improvement going forward over the next decade. In fact, if you look at the historical median for the net margins of Alibaba, it's around 26.6%. Relative to the current net margins of only 6.41%, there is massive room for improvement there. And that same trend stands true in relation to operating margins. Operating margins are with a median of 28.87 over the past decade, currently standing now at only 11.11. Massive room for growth there. It's the same story with gross margins. Gross margins have had a median of around 60% over the past decade, yet now only sit at 36.76%. So, as the CCP continues to withdraw from this company, as the secular trends continue to propel it going forward, positive secular momentum around a number of business units within this company, there's massive growth potential there. Massive room for reinvigoration within this business. So, fairly appealing. I think this company has room for margin reinvigoration going forward, and also the financial stability is already very much present within the company. Everything you're after in a long-term investment prospect, present within Alibaba. But what about the valuation? People see that PE ratio, that very high PE ratio of 38.93, and they naturally think, well, you know, that PE ratio is too high. Got to be staying away from that. Can't possibly be buying a company with a PE ratio of 38.93 in a market that's been absolutely crushing anything with a large degree of growth predication. It's simply not logical at all. But look at the forward PE ratio. The forward PE ratio is only 13.36. So there's a massive differential between the current PE ratio of 38 and the forward PE ratio of only 13.36. What does this discrepancy in PE ratio tells us? Well, it tells us that going forward, investors in the market more broadly, they believe this company can execute massive growth, massive, massive growth, so much so that the current PE ratio would be reduced all the way down to a PE ratio of only 13.36. So why does this massive discrepancy become apparent? Why is this massive discrepancy apparent within this company? Well, it comes down to one key factor. Over the course of the past 12 months, yes, there's been a substantial decline to the stock price of Alibaba, but also a substantial earnings decline. An earnings decline of negative 57.4%. And that massive growth drop-off has kind of skewed the growth numbers. With that massive decline, you can't really get a fair valuation based upon the current earnings of only $3.09 on a trailing basis. So, to get a fair value for Alibaba, we're going to take the earnings back from March of 2021, back when earnings were normalized before this drop-off in earnings. And if we take the earnings figure back from 2021, so about $8.40 a share, we input that into our calculation, and then we input a growth rate of, say, 5.8% only, 5.8% going forward, discount rate of 9%, that reflected earnings per share figure of $8.40 a share. Look at that fair value. Fair value of $120.17. That's the reality of this company. The reality of the opportunity evident within this business. Think about it. You're getting fair value even with that very conservative growth rate of 5.8%. But what happens if we up that growth rate? What happens if we get more rational here? What happens if we think, listen, these secular trends not only propelling their platform e-commerce business forward, but also their cloud business. Massive growth across the Chinese economy more broadly. So would a 15% rate of growth be that unreasonable? I don't think so. They've been compounding at around 31.8% consistently over the past decade. So a growth rate less than half of that wouldn't seem unjustified at all. Now if we input that, growth rate of 15% going forward over the next decade, discount rate of 9%, current earnings per share figure of $8.40 a share, look at that fair value. Fair value of $226.02, a margin of safety of 46.85%. That is the reality of this marketplace. It's the reality of Alibaba stock right now. Massive, massive undervaluation. Relative to the current trading price, you look at an almost 2x your money prospect, even with these highly favorable secular trends around the business. Yes, the stock is up a lot. Yes, the stock has risen up massively from that low of around $81, but I believe there's still opportunity present. I believe there's still undervaluation evident within this business, with attention moving away from the stock. No longer as many eyes on the company. Now appears to be the perfect time to start a position. So of course, conduct your own research first, look into the company before you make any moves. But if you enjoyed this video, if you learned something more about my current thoughts on Alibaba relative to the market more broadly, then please drop us a like down below, hit subscribe if you haven't already. If there's a company or a topic you want me to talk about in the next video, then please just comment down below. We'd love to hear your thoughts. But until then, thank you. I'll see you in the next one.